So you'll reverse your attack?
Yeah, that's good.
In the early 2000s, Professor Kevin Du knew he wanted to find ways to get his students hands-on experience in cybersecurity.
From my background, I learned much better when I do something. Yeah, so then I decide, okay, I should develop some of the get the student to work some exercises. Yeah, but that time there was not much going on from internet. So I decide I would just develop my own for my own class at Syracuse University.
Du developed labs where students could simulate cyber attacks and identify security flaws and mistakes in software.
Turns out students like that very much. And they are very passionate about this. So then I decided, okay, maybe other people like that.
Du and his students developed the SEED labs at Syracuse University, cybersecurity exercises, research, and software that could be used by other schools.
Using this lab itself sometimes takes some learning. And so I also got a grant from National Science Foundation and to actually train other professors, especially professors who are new into this area. And so to teach them how to use that. So they come to Syracuse for 4 days and the training, and they will take whatever learned back to their class. So far at 600 universities worldwide, and in about more than 30 countries are using my labs.
High profile cyber attacks have shown hackers can exploit even small mistakes.
In the past, just one computer is maybe open to the outside. Now, 10th device in your home, so you have 10 doors open, you don't even know.
Using secure computers in Du's workshops on the Syracuse University campus, professors can mimic attacks on networks and programs and then see how the security flaws were exploited.
Very, very common techniques used by the attacker.
These are exercises that can only be done in a controlled environment.
It would be tough to do in limited resources, and it would be almost impossible to do safely. So it's very kind of folks at research universities like Syracuse that they share what they've developed with the grad students and all that kind of thing.
Yeah.
With public universities that don't have the resources.
Practical experience that could secure countless devices and networks we rely on every day.
And we continue to see that if you want students to really understand what this is all about, they've got to do hands-on. They've got to work directly with the software, work directly with see the vulnerabilities, understand how those vulnerabilities could be exploited. And you can only do that in an environment such as this. So what Kevin and his students have done is really an extraordinary resource for people that are teaching in this space.
So we're trying to educate our students. So when they actually write a program and they know that the attacker is going to attack in such a way, so they don't make the same mistake. And as a result, their system is going to be more robust, more secure.